TrueShot Reacts is back again. How we doing, Rich?
Bro, look at this hoodie, huh? Not bad.
That is pretty fancy. Where can I snag me one of those?
I got this from our merch store. I got this from TrueShot.BigCartel.com. Brand new hoodie design, paradigm inspired. Let me get up here and show the fine people of the internet the back design. Look at that thing, huh? It's got all the lyrics written by yours truly on the back there. And I don't even know if you can see because I don't know what's behind
You're kind of there. You're a little stage left.
All right,
that's
well,
okay.
They can go on the website and look at it. $35. You know, very, very cheap. Cost us $70 to make them. So we're losing money. And they're dipped in gold. No. But yeah, guys, head on over to our merch store, trueshot.bigcartel.com. Hoodies over there for $35. We got some other t-shirts up there for about $10 a piece. We're also doing a deal right now with free shipping anywhere in the U.S. Up to 50, free shipping over $50 for anywhere in the U.S. using the promo code SHIP50USA. Yeah, guys. So Adam, what are we doing right now?
It's funny you're talking about the sweatshirts. The guitarist of this band, Parts Per Million, who is going to be featured again. This is the second time. Paul McSweeney, he reached out. We were talking about some other stuff, and I said, hey, you got any new music coming out? He alluded to this, and I said, done. So it came out today. We're going to react to it right now. So Paul McSweeney bought a sweatshirt. That's why I was bringing that up.
He did. And now, Paul, listen, I know you bought a sweatshirt. And so, I mean, that doesn't buy positive comments for me. Okay, if you buy 5 sweatshirts, maybe I'll throw you in a compliment here or there. But see, here's the thing, Paul. I'm not a big rock music guy. That's very well known.
You did dig the last track.
I did dig the last one. Hopefully he continues that. Hopefully he didn't get complacent and comfortable since he got the good grace from me on the last. So maybe he thought he could just coast. But
I don't know. So he and the guys of Parts Per Million have been promoting this one hard. I don't know if it has anything. I don't know what to expect. So he didn't. Right. I told him, don't tell me anything. We'll react to it when it comes out. So.
All right. Sounds good. Let's. Just give me the okay when to play. Oh, 5 minutes. Come on, Paul. All right. Anyway, just give me the go ahead for when to hit play.
All right. Let's. Let's get this going. All right. Here we go.
Thank you.
rip it. Pushing it.
Okay.
You got to go first on this one. Oh, hold on. I didn't finish it. Hold on.
So I got to go first, huh?
There we go. Yeah, you got to go first on this one.
Okay. So first of all, I want to kind of talk about, you know, instrumentally, it was very good. You know, like you had mentioned the bass tone. I noticed that. That was really, really, that was a cool bass tone. You could really like hear it in the mix well.
Mm-hmm.
I thought that was nice. Guitar work was really well. You know, they had like a pseudo breakdown in there.
Yep.
Kind of like a, you know, like a, I don't know, do you call them breakdowns in rock music? Sure, right?
I don't know. Let people tell us what they call them.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if that's what you call them or not.
Maybe breakdown obviously light.
The guitar work was solid enough. Paul's vocals, you know, he pushed it at that one point toward the end of the song, really pushed it up another octave or two there, which I thought was a nice touch. But he had like that, you know, that same just kind of like, wow, who was the example you used last time?
I don't remember.
I know it was, I know you mentioned like kind of like a Chris Cornell, but it wasn't like quite Chris Cornell. It was somebody else. You know, that very kind of like softer, like kind of
not Soundgarden.
I can't think of who, but he, you know, he has a nice voice. You know, he can sing really well. I like the message of the song. You know, it's just kind of obviously in this day and age, politics are a big to do. You know, it's become a very tribal kind of thing. You know, like us versus them kind of thing. It's never. You know, just being people to people, you know, you kind of base who you want to be friends with or socialize with based off of their political affiliation, whoever they vote for every 4 years, which I think is absolutely ridiculous. I think it's very possible to be friends and socialize, interact with people who don't share that political belief with you. And I know that, Adam, obviously you're older than I am, but I don't recall that ever really being an issue. You know, you look back, you know, 5 years ago, that was just never like the thing that
it
came
wasn't,
up with.
I don't think it was as polarizing.
Yeah.
I feel like there's a lot of less middle ground discussed, and it's really like my way or the highway. If you're not in my lane, then I'm running you over, or I'm going to get off the exit and I'm not even going to deal with you.
Right. So the video did a nice job showing that, you know, the two different households, their different beliefs, them, you know, saying stuff for the television, and then, you know, they get together in the video and they're fighting and arguing.
That was a good freaking video, though.
Yeah. And then I like the part, you know, they go through the wall, which to me symbolizes, you know, they kind of see behind the curtain. Like these, I mean, let's be honest, you know, like no matter who you vote for or whatever, at the end of the day, like, do these people really care about you? Like, that's the thing that I think is so interesting, is that do they really care about you as an individual at the end of the day? No, it's want power and all that. But anyway, though, I just thought that the video did a really nice job of symbolizing that. And I mean, for what it is, you know, it's a solid track. It's a pleasant rock song. It should, you know, it's a radio friendly song. I think that would do well on that kind of platform.
I liked it, man. I thought it was pretty good. I liked the little the solo there. He ripped up a little bit. I love the vocals. To me, it's just like 90s grunge rock at its best. The Soundgarden times,
right.
The Alice in Chains, like the last one kind of had that sort of feel to it. So I dug it, man. I'm glad we decided to fit that one in tonight.
Yeah. I mean, even lyrics-wise, I think there's some really cool lines in here. It says right here, dance for colors, you know, it's a race to die. So dance for colors, you know, you got the red and the blue for the different political affiliations. And it says,
yep.
When I say jump, you say, sir, how high? And that's, to me, it's very bizarre. You know, you get these people who you never met come on the television that you support in a presidential campaign. And all of a sudden, for some people, not everybody, but that becomes, you know, how they want to demonstrate their everyday life. I think that's very bizarre to me. There can be a middle ground. But anyways, enough of the political stuff. We're only talking about that because of the content
of
the
video.
And I think that Paul and the guys in Parts Per Million did a nice job presenting that. Especially, I like the title. It's a play on words, you know, 2020.
Vision.
2020 Vision.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
I thought it was a super solid track. No, I thought it was really good.
All right.
Their production is really good, too. I mean, their guitar tones are really good. Their bass tone was solid. The mix was really balanced. I mean, his vocals. We haven't seen them live, and I can't wait to see them live to watch that. I mean, that's good. So, I dug it, man. Let's head out to the next one. Do your spiel.
Yeah, so before you guys head out of here, make sure you like and subscribe to the channel here. Also, turn on the notification bell so you get notified when we release new content here on the channel. Comment down below and tell us what you thought of Parts Per Million and their song 2020 Vision. And make sure you follow us on all of our social medias at TrueShot Band. You can find us there on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Make sure you check out our music. We're TrueShot on all of your favorite streaming platforms, such as Apple Music, Spotify, Deezer, Amazon, and Google Play. Until the next one, guys, we will see you later. Peace.